trying to explain to people that the pundits can be very entertaining, but it's not really.
What's your opinion of pundits? Come on, shoot from the hip.
If pundits were on the ballot against, like, I don't know.
Ebola?
I might vote Ebola. Or third party.
Sabermetrics got me checking in to see what she would win in the world of Scott. Some player personnel reports he developed a course to let the little guy contend. Until one day, set his sights upon the highest office to hold in the USA. First name Nate, last name Silver, gold in the game. Who's the only blogger? Got the New York Times in the palm of his hand. Even when Obama lost the first debate, no, it didn't shake Nate. His prediction would stand. Quantitative analysis led him to predict almost every single state in the race. Though you don't know his face, if you win this political game, then you probably heard about the man. Nate. Yeah, rational progressivism, economic discipline, and intellectual wisdom. From the sum of the total of the info he's given, and the system couldn't handle all that's within him. Tell me the forecast, and get through the noise with the signal blast. Cause I think back in time about the lies, damn lies, in baseball perspectives back when I read that. Tell me how's he do it, and he's trying his best to build a rubric. Trying not to lose it, still he's got the press confused like he's Stanley Kubrick. Some say it's math, some say it's intuition, and some say lucky hits. Some don't believe in the science of math, and some believe that Nate Silver's a witch.
Frustrate narratives that are told by pundits and journalists that don't have a lot of grounding in objective reality, frankly.
Nate Silver's a witch. Then I hope that we aren't on his bad side, cause if history's any indication, probably wouldn't win if he tried to be a bad guy. Nate Silver's a witch. Then I guess that I gotta re-examine everything I thought about science and life and the way we used to do it in the past times. Right. To the haters, y'all 2000 and late, cause you ain't in the game without 538. And I'm sick of the games that the press tried to play when they push on the new issue of the day. Cause they gotta sell ads in the race of the horse for Rupert Murdoch and the Judge Report. And the CNN war room's gotta pay for all the holograms and touch screens to report. Thank God, some trust in probability, mathematical model, statistical tools. Cause it's common sense that if the math adds up and we as a society can't back up to the dark ages, where we based our opinions on the talking heads on the screen. And if Galileo got jailed for his beliefs, then I guess that we gotta start a new campaign.
Free Nate Silver, he can fill in the blanks where the press and media can, when the pundits keep shooting blanks and the corporations all try to stand over common women and men. But just check that update again, you can take that shit to the bank.
Nate Silver's a witch. Then I hope that we aren't on his bad side, cause if history's any indication, probably wouldn't win if he tried to be a bad guy.
Nate Silver's a witch.
Then I guess that I gotta re-examine everything I thought about science and life and the way we used to do it in the past times, right?
Nate Silver's a witch. I said he's a witch. If he's a witch, that's okay with me. Nate Silver's a witch.